Welcome back, everyone, to WWF Wrestling Challenge. Jim Ross and Bobby the Brain Heenan back with you. And what a main event it will be at the King of the Ring competition of June 13th. Hulk Hogan and Yokozuna one-on-one for the WWF title, Brain.
Well, this time Yokozuna can prepare himself. This time he's got himself a couple of months to really get ready. And I'm talking about getting ready for the five-time WWF champion Hulk Hogan. Hulkamania is going to be finished.
Plus, we have learned that Bret Hart has been seated number one in the King of the Ring tournament. And I think that is one of the better decisions that Jack Tunney has made in the last few weeks.
Well, you don't understand. You're new here. Being number one seed means that you have greased the palm of Jack Tunney. That means he bought his way into it.
I don't believe that whatsoever.
Eat your heart out, Tunney.
Well, we are going to see this qualifying matchup for the King of the Ring competition. The winner of this competition will join Bret Hart in the tournament. If we can ever get the mirror out of the ring and
join him,
he'll get to admire himself. This guy really is
and
full of himself. And here's one of the most down-to-earth, one of the nicest guys ever in the WWE.
At 234 pounds from Mayberry, O.B. Taylor.
It's Bob Backlund, and he's from North Dakota State University, Bobby the Brain.
Wow.
And he was also, you can say wow for the fact that he was, for about 6 years, the WWF champion.
North Dakota State? What do you have to do there to graduate? People milk a cow with your left hand?
A fine institution, and they have a great wrestling program.
Oh, they certainly do. Tomorrow, Elmer, maybe you can drive the truck, and I'll talk to the pig.
Hey, everybody can't be born with a silver spoon in their mouth and have a chauffeur named Jennifer, who told me, by the way, that she hasn't had a raise in several months.
She said that?
Yes.
She's fired. I'm going to load her just like I found her. You need a job on the weekends?
I'm a little bit busy on the weekends.
Oh, that's so right. You just drive pickup trucks.
Backlund, quick go behind. And he cradles Luger. Near fall situation. Backlund hooks the arms. He's right behind Luger. And Luger able to kick out at two. Luger now trying a slam inside cradle by Backlund. Backlund is taking the big man off his feet. Another arm drag takeover. Single leg. Backlund has Luger confused. And the big man off his feet, Backlund up and over. Did he predict him? Did he get him here?
Oh, that
was close. Luger's got to get outside to regroup. And the narcissist is not very happy.
I like the strategy that Opie's using here. He's going right after him. He's trying to pin him about four or five times. He's taking it right to Lex Luger. He's not laying back. That's good strategy right there. But I don't think it's going to work. You know, he's 43 years old. Bob Backlund, he's been out of the WWF for about 7 or 8 years. He did hold that title for 6, 7 years. That takes a lot out of you. But he's in tremendous shape for his age. But you can't compare him to Lex Luger. It's like comparing horse manure to ice cream.
Well, Luger is 6'5", 275, has a definite strength and obviously size advantage over Bob Backlund. But he's also got something that you can't measure, and that's that steel plate that is in his right forearm that has knocked everyone absolutely unconscious that he has faced.
Boy, he's had more hits than Elvis.
Luger back in the ring now. He needs to control the tempo here because Backlund started off very, very quickly, and Backlund does have a quickness advantage. Backlund has him in the ropes.
And,
well, good sportsmanship by Backlund, but he paid for it, perhaps. Put the elbow right in the face.
Well, you have good sportsmanship. You go to North Nebraska State, wherever he's from.
North Dakota State.
Same thing, same neck of the woods.
Well, Lex Luger, I talked with him earlier today, and after he got through talking about himself for about a half an hour, he did get around to talking about Bret the Hitman Hart, and that's going to be a tremendous matchup, Hart and Luger one-on-one.
Oh, and you know, and Bret Hart, in the back of his mind, he's not forgetting how he was knocked out cold at the WrestleMania breakfast brunch, and that had something to do with him losing that title, too. You know, he rattled his cage pretty good.
You're exactly right about that. It was a cheap shot. Luger caught him from behind, blindsided him.
Doesn't matter what you call it as long as you get the shot in.
Luger, Irish whip, that's going to be reversed by Backlund. And Backlund whip knocks Luger over, scoops him up. Bobby Backlund took his fresh left.
Oh, he's home, boy.
Drop kick caught Luger in the face. Backlund now showing some offensive spark. Has Luger up, a coming drop. He'll compress the vertebra there. Luger in trouble.
He's going right in for the pin. He wants it.
Got him rolled up. Oh, Luger's quick leg strength. Backlund was going to roll back with him in that vintage move of his, but Luger's leg strength was too much for Backlund to overcome.
The heat and cradle.
The heat and cradle.
Stole that from me,
I've
too.
I've never heard that term used in my career.
Yeah, but you went to South Dakota State.
No, I didn't.
Oh, that's right. You're a jokey from Muskogee, wherever they call you.
Backlund pulling his way back up on the apron. And, he caught him right there. He caught him with that forearm. And Backlund knocked all the way down the aisle. And he is not moving. He's out of it.
I can't see from my vantage point here. Luger looks great.
He caught him with that controversial forearm. And the referee, Bill Alfonso, exercising his count, and Luger's going to win it by a count out, and he will advance in the King of the Ring tournament.
Well, where's Backlund?
The winner of this match.
Backlund is out cold.
The Narcissist,
Lex Luger. Oh, yeah.
So Luger advances in the King of the Ring competition. Fans, we've got more action coming your way.